Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and in this lesson we are going to look at what I call as displaced octave arpeggios, a nice technique to take some commonly used arpeggio patterns like this and make it sound very unique and develop a very original vibe, if you will, to suit like a hook which you could make in your song, okay? And make your arpeggios really stand out and be rememberable. So this particular lesson is part of an entire lesson series, if you will, on how to make arpeggios unique, original, professional and whatnot. So check out the description. There's a playlist and a lot of links to show you other lessons which I've done on this subject. I love talking about arpeggios, and there are a lot of lessons which we've done and which I want to keep doing. Okay, and if you haven't already, it'll be great if you could turn on that bell for notifications and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. It'll be awesome to have you on board. Okay, so let's get started with displaced octave arpeggios. So if you take four chords in this exercise, I'm taking E minor, G major, D major, and A major. Okay, four chords. Now, commonly used approach which you will find to play arpeggios would be just played in a cyclic loop starting from the bottom. It'll be something like, in this case, L, M, H, M, L, M, H, M, L, M, H, M. So it's a very commonly used arpeggio style, right? And I have taught the commonly used stuff as well in the, check out the description, and all the links are there for you to watch, okay? The whole point of this lesson is to make the arpeggio pattern sound unique and original. So now, if you take the same thing, L, M, H, M, L, M, H, M, so what I mean by displaced octave arpeggios is where you take the bottom note or the top note of the chord, and instead of repeating it at the same point, in this case the bottom point, so that'll be L, M, H, M, low, middle, high, middle. Instead of repeating that again, we can keep it a bit interesting by repeating it an octave above. So E, G, B, G, instead of playing that E again, we go an octave up. So E, G, B, G, E, G, B, G. Okay, it's still E, G, B, G, E, G, B, G, but E, G, B, G, E, G, B, G. That's a displaced octave, as I'm calling it. So you have E, G, B, G, E, G, B, G. Okay, so it appears as though there are four notes, but there are only three unique notes. The fourth note is a repetition of one of the notes. So E, G, B, G, E, G, B, G. Why don't you play it along with me and keep four fingers ready for this arpeggio? You need four because there are four notes. One got displaced here. So thumb, index, middle, and the pinky. Thumb and the pinky are important while playing octaves of any form. So you go L, M, H, M, L, M, H. Play along. L, M, H, M, L, M, H, M, L, M, H, M. Okay. Okay, so that's E minor. Then we have G major, which I'm playing like this using the inversion. So that's D, G, B. So you need to again copy the D up top. Okay, D, G, B, G, D. So let's do the two chords, E minor and G major. G major. E minor again. G major. Get used to the grip and then change over to the other chord, D major. This is the normal shape. Okay, so if I do LM, HM, LM, HM, tends to sound a bit redundant or repetitive. So HM, LM, HM. I play the top L. Okay, LM, HM, LM, HM. And lastly, A major, I'm playing E, A, C sharp. And again, take the low note, find its octave, E, E, and you get yourself a displaced octave arpeggio. So let's look at all our chords again. E minor. Get used to the handhold and the fingers. G major. I'm using my ring finger here. G major. Now D major. A major. Okay, so for some chords I need my ring finger for the third note. For some chords I need my middle finger for the third note. Let's put it all together and play along if you can. E minor. G major. D major. A major. Da-da, E minor. G major. D major. A major. Little faster. E minor. Can count 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And also put in some expression. One way is obviously volume can keep changing. Get louder, get softer. Also, you can use the pedal. The pedal creates those overtones. You could also highlight the drum kit. You can look at accentuating the snare drum. Play the snare hits, whatever you imagine as the snares, a little harder. And yeah, I've also done a separate lesson on this, on how to make your arpeggios go from nice, good sounding to pro level. So check that out as well in the description. Okay, so this is about an octave displaced arpeggio, and we've displaced the note at the low point or in the left or the bottom note. Let's now displace it from the top note or the high note, if you will. So I need to re-angle my fingers a bit, taking B there, and I can do, start with the high note, high, middle, low, middle, high, middle, low, middle. Now this sounds nice, doesn't sound very unique. So to make it unique, take the high note, find its octave. What is this note? B. Find B here and try to displace the B every alternate time. So B, G, E, G, B, G, E, G. B, G, E, G, B, G, E, G. Right? Another interesting sound. Then. And then. And then. Those are your chords. So let's try and play this up to speed. Right? So for the most part, you could take one of the notes of your chord, L, and create a unique arpeggio by taking that note and playing it up an octave, or you can take the top note and put that down an octave, right? Or if you just take the bottom note and take it up an octave and, you know, alternate that, that itself should sound very unique and very interesting. It creates a very guitar-like or a banjo-like or a finger-style kind of chord arrangement pattern, right? Because these instruments like the guitar or the banjo or a mandolin, they have a lot of strings and people play them with three or four fingers and they are able to look at all sorts of finger permutations. And when we play chords, again, it's three or four notes. So it's important to just get accustomed to things which you would find string players do. And this whole technique pretty much came from what string players do, right? You would observe guitar players doing this, bread and butter for them. It's just a standard pattern. And we just try to play it. We just try to follow them and create a unique sound. And I think this approach is very logically understandable because it's the same note. It's just copied up And that makes it unique because the pitch gets displaced. Right, guys, again, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. Thanks a ton for watching this lesson. And if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, turn on the bell icon for notifications, and share the lesson with all your friends. Cheers.